welcome to the Harvest Money Show. I am your host, Jackie Achan. Now, in the last episode of the Harvest Money Show, we did talk to Dr. Stanley Calvo, and he was telling us how we can prepare our land ready for the bean planting season. If I could remember what he said last week, he said we need to start in January preparations for the land, and then until, you know, February. And then when the rains come in March, we are quite set, and we should be able to use the second or third rain to make the most out of that soil to get, you know, good yields out of the beans we plant. Now, today we want to talk about the, you know, variety of seed we choose, the bean seeds we choose to plant. What does it entail to pick a good seed? So with me again is Dr. Stanley Calvo at the National Agriculture Research Organization, a serious researcher, a senior researcher who is going to take us, you know, through the whole process of selecting your, you know, bean seed so that you can have a good yield for your, you know, the beans you plant this season. So Dr. Calvo, you're welcome yet again.
Thank you.
This time I want you to tell us, when we are ready to plant, what kind of seed should any farmer go for? What are those qualities somebody needs to look out for? Or is it just a straightforward thing? I just pick any bean seed and go and plant. So I want to get that insight for you, for our farmers who are listening in to you right now.
Thank you. Thank you, Jackie. Yeah, seed is critical. And seed is the most important ingredient in as far as any crop is concerned. If you get the seed wrong, you get the crop and the yield wrong. Okay? As beans is concerned, we know the different varieties. And somehow, we also expect the farmers to have their preferences, depending on, first of all, their regions, and depending on their markets. Okay, because it doesn't pay for you to have a market that is doing red mottled and you're growing yellow beans. Okay, so you must know, if I'm going to do red mottled, what are the best varieties? Where can I get the variety? Where can I get the seed? I know a lot of farmers use home saved seed,
yes,
but this has a lot of issues due to there are a lot of disease that is carried within the seed. There are a lot of mixes that go along with the different seeds, because of some of them are a little bit uniform. Narrow does the initial seed. I do the what we call the breeder seed. We work with Narrow Holdings, which is a private company that does foundation seed for all the seed companies. Okay, now foundation seed is the second purest form of seed. The first purest form of seed is a breeder seed, which comes from me. It's normally 99.9% pure. Okay, then we have Narrow Holdings that does foundation seed, which at the end of it may be about 90 to 99% pure. From Narrow Holdings, we have what we call the certified seed that is grown by the seed companies. But because the seed companies can't be everywhere, we have a channel for what we call quality declared seed that is grown by farmer groups that are registered at the sub-county level, that are mandated within the region to grow quality declared seed. But that quality declared seed is supposed to remain within that region. They are not supposed, for example, if you're in Rukunjiri, you can't sell your quality declared seed in PG. So you have to sell it within Rukunjiri. The farmer has to, first of all, know, as I've said before, what variety you are going to grow, okay, because of your location to your market, okay, and possibly your preference. You want to consume, that could be it. Now, within the country, there are certain varieties that can grow all around the country, okay. For example, most of the red mottled varieties like Nabe 17, Nabe 16,
They almost look alike.
Yes, yes, that's what I said. Yeah, they are. If you looked at them,
they're not.
Yes, and that's so. If I gave farmers these two varieties, okay, farmers will end up mixing them, and that's what I talked about, the mixes that leads to degrading of the seed varieties. Okay, now there are some unique varieties, like the yellow beans. Now, a lot of people like to grow yellow beans and consume yellow beans because of the taste, because of the cooking capability, and some because of the flatulence. They have very low flatulence or gas. Some people eat beans and get gas. Now, these beans do well in western part of the country. Yes, the farmer may grow it here, but he won't get as much as the farmer in western part of the country. We haven't zeroed down on why particularly the western part of the country. For the other regions, you have only patches of areas where you can. But if you really want to maximize, please, if you're in the central, if you're in the northern part of the country, the western part of the country, eastern part of the country, don't go for yellow beans, because you won't get as much yield as the person who does it
and
in the western part of
no
the country.
Why it does
for now, we don't have answers as to why yellow does that, but at least we've noted that that's where yellow does best, and we are trying to breed against that, and possibly our future materials will be universal for the country. Now, we have a variety like narrow bean one.
Which one? What is the name locally?
Locally, they want to call it masavu, but we have two types of masavu. Okay. We have a climber that does well in the highland areas, that the Kisoro, Kabale, Kapchora, Sironko, up north, Abbey region, Rua West, you know, where the cooler environments. But this one, the bush, the other one is round. Unfortunately, they haven't brought it here. The other one's round. This one is a bit kidney. Okay? The kidney one's a bush one. That can do well across the region.
The kidney masavu.
The kidney masavu.
This one is not.
Is a bush semi-climber that can be grown around the country. It's one of the varieties that you can grow around the country without problems. Also, the red mottoes can also do well across the country.
This one, the local name is?
Normally, what farmers give it nambale, nambale short, nambale round, nambale whatever. but for us, we stick to the names. Nabe 16, for example, this is Nabe 16, the Nabe 17, and we also have Nabe 19, which is and also this is an old variety, Nabe 4, which we are soon taking off the market. We improve these varieties and maintain what farmers prefer. Okay, because if we brought something totally new, farmers will still yearn for. But when we slowly change, farmers still stick to the color. For example, farmers, when you take new varieties of this series, this one we've been growing it. But at least we know that we've improved because of a certain trait that we're incorporating.
Now let me ask you, like a consumer who perhaps has just chanced on the show, and I'm to seeing you talking about improving variety, changing things in the bean to get a certain variety, I might be concerned about the taste. Is it still going to be the same bean when I cook it and test it?
Yes, we are very particular about the tests, and the test has to go through a series of tests by the consumers for us to approve whether it is liked or not. Then if you're in areas where there's a little bit of drought, you look for, although it does well everywhere, but we're in an area that's a little bit sandy, that's a little bit dry, and you're not sure of the weather, the season, you know, then you can go for narrow bean 6. It's drought tolerant with narrow bean 7. These are drought tolerant varieties. But this one's for the people in the northern part of the country, as I told you, and possibly southwest. They eat black beans. In the center, they don't eat black beans. But if you have a market for black beans, It doesn't mean you can't grow it in the central and sell it to Kenya where they consume it, or to the northern part of the country where you're committing. So you'll be growing it as a market crop, not as a consumption crop. So let not farmers grow things that they can only consume, but let them grow things that they can consume to make money. These two varieties, in all these varieties, are the highest yielding. When you have smaller seed, the yield is slightly higher than the bigger bush beans, okay? But two, you need less to plant an acre than you need on the others. The seed size determines how much seed you require, okay? A lot of people don't talk about, when we talk about an acre, people talk about 30 kilos and whatever, you know. But each variety has a specific amount of seed that you need to utilize because of their seed size. For bigger seed, we normally plant between 30 to 35 kilograms per acre. For smaller seed like this one, you plant about 15 to 20 kilograms per acre. And yet, yes, each kilo of seed goes for the same amount of money.
Regardless
of whether it is small or big. So economically, you start calculating that if I want an acre, I could use the same amount of money to plant more than when I plant a large seeded variety. Okay, so look at your area, look at your goal, your aim, and look at what is available. Then, after that, you have to to know where to get the different sources of seed. Okay, normally a lot of people call me, and then I'll refer them either to Narrow Holdings or the different seed companies, depending on where they are. We have different people or different seed companies within the different regions producing seed for the different farmers, okay? And at times we have collaborations, know what variety they have, because we already know now what variety they are certified for. So we can guide depending on where you get the call. But I request the farmers that they talk to their sub-counties, because the sub-counties have agriculture extension officers who have information on where these materials are. Or if they don't, then they know who to call to be able to ensure that farmers have the right seed or can source for the right seed. As I said, it's very important to have the right kind of seed. Seed that is mixed normally results in, I've seen a lot of rust disease hampering seeds that have been mixed. I've seen a lot of diseases hampering seeds that are, you know, and also those differences in the growth types have a lot of issues in as far as creating either environments suitable for sun penetration and thus reduction of disease and things like that. But I've seen that mixes normally result in a lot of disease issues within the crop.